控制我自己，不会让谁。
What up? Welcome to another episode of Storytime with Sascha. I'm Sascha. Today I'm going to tell a story about a character from this novel that I'm working on. So I've been working on a novel for 5 years, and I'm really, really close to finishing it. So I thought it would be a good time to start talking about some of these characters and giving the backstories and kind of, you know, not just for, you know, the Storytime channel, but also for myself, just kind of, you know, getting these juices flowing. So the character we're going to talk about today is Du Juan. And Du Juan is a dwarf. And she was born in a small town in Yunnan province, which is the southernmost province of China, borders Laos and Thailand. And this town is called Chuxiong. That's the name of the town. And Yunnan is a beautiful province. You know, it has soaring mountains, tea hills, lots of ethnic minorities, a lot of interesting villages. It was an important stop on the Southern Silk trade route, which not too many people know about, but the one that went from Tibet into China, then south through Yunnan into like Burma and across to India. So another trade route. So it's a very beautiful place. Lots of tourists go there. Lots of people travel there. There's, you know, hippie towns filled with Chinese who want to escape the rat race. It's a cool spot. Chuxiong is one of those cities that just missed the boat. Perhaps some of you have been to, you know, beautiful parts of the world that are known as tourist destinations, and there will be a town that just, where the river of prosperity just kind of flowed around it. That's Chuxiong, okay? So Chuxiong is a shithole. It is always muddy, broke. People there don't like outsiders. They're frustrated, they're angry. There ain't shit going on in Chuxiong, all right? So now, in China, if you're born a dwarf, that's your ass, right? It's not a friendly place for people with disabilities. Especially back when this woman was born, which is in the 1980s, okay? It's not a friendly spot. And, you know, China's the type of spot where people aborted their baby girls because there was a one-child policy and they would rather have sons, right? So that happened a lot, to the point where there's a discrepancy in male and female populations in China. And if you're a female dwarf, the chances of you actually making it through into adulthood are low. And, you know, people are going to dispute it, I'm sure. And these days it's different. You know, it's 2024 now. This isn't, you know, 1984. But that's just what it is. You know, it doesn't matter what anyone says now or feels about it. That's just the way things were, definitely. So Du Juan was born, and her parents realized that she was a dwarf. And instead of immediately aborting her, they decided to sell her, okay? Which is also, was once, and might still be, but definitely was once common practice, you know, for children with disabilities to be sold, okay? This is what it is, man. So her parents, they probably thought, by the way, this is a fictional character in a novel I'm writing. Just making sure everyone knows that. But anyway, her parents were like, yo, we can sell this girl, take the money, buy a pig, come up, and then try again for a boy later. So that's what they did. And they sold Du Juan to a traveling dwarf circus. And if you look up dwarfs in China, there's one huge story about a circus in Yunnan that, you know, a dwarf circus in Yunnan. Like, you can look that up. It actually existed as early as, 15 years ago, 20 years ago maybe. So in the 90s, you know, in the early 90s, there definitely was one of these circuses. So she was sold into the circus, and this circus had like a dwarf strongman, dwarves in costumes running around, dwarves playing with monkeys. And for Du Juan, turns out that she was a dwarf, but she was also beautiful. She's a beautiful girl, has a beautiful face. A little bit malformed, you know, maybe a head a little bit bigger, you know, hands a little bit smaller, and obviously she's a dwarf, but she's beautiful. And so she was immediately put to work as a sex worker. So probably not, you know, as a child, but as soon as she was old enough, her job in the circus was to be sexy. And so now I'm going to get into some of the inspirations, right? So you're like a dwarf born in Chuxiong, a shithole, a dwarf circus, sex worker, Sasha, it's crazy. Oh no, it is not crazy. See, truth is much stranger than fiction. I was in a town in Yunnan. That was one of these shitholes, you know, right beside a very beautiful and bustling tourist town. Was kind of the pimple on the ass of this town, right? And I, you know, the pimple on the ass of this town had stuff that you needed. That's where the, you know, hardware stores were and stuff like that. So I was going with a buddy to a hardware store there to buy something for his dishwasher or his washing machine. I can't remember. And we got coaxed into this dwarf circus performance on the second floor of this grimy ass building. And there was a dwarf, like the girl that I'm envisioning, like Du Juan, who took a shine to my buddy, and she didn't want him to leave. She kept tugging on him, and you know, there was a strong man there. So this character is drawn from personal experience. You know, there's more actually that I'll get to in a little bit, but she's drawn from personal experience. So anyway, Du Juan, this character in my book, dwarf sex worker working in a circus. And after, you know, traveling the countryside, putting on shows and, you know, giving head to random farmers for 5-6 years, she takes the money that she's allowed to keep and decides she's going to go it alone. And after a lot of wandering, you know, across China, different towns, you know, different markets, different brothels, she arrives in Chengdu, which is the capital of Sichuan province, the province just north of Yunnan. And so, to give you the character of Du Juan, she's hard as nails, right? She grew up tough. Nobody wanted her, right? She was treated like dog shit from the very beginning. The only family she had were the other dwarves in this circus. And even they, you know, even though they stuck together, they would come and go. Some of them would die, some would get kidnapped, you know, some would run off, you know. So she grew up, there's many things that can happen to a person that grows up like that, but, you know, Du Juan, she was born again hard, you know. By the time she was 18, 19 and took off for Chengdu, very streetwise, and she learned how to manipulate men. She realized, like, okay, I'm a dwarf, and like, there's this, you know, tendency to kind of treat me like I'm an animal, but I'm also sexy, and men are weird. Men want to fuck, you know, cripples, dwarves, burn victims. I mean, there's men out there like that, believe it. And so she realized quickly that she had power over men. Her sexuality and her brazen confidence and kind of like streetwise, you know, hard look managed to give her power over definitely women and many men. So in Chengdu, we're going to come across some more personal inspiration. So there were two things that inspired this character. One was this experience in Yunnan in the shithole with this dwarf circus. And the other was, so in 2001, 2002, along the river in the city of Chengdu, the river that runs right through the center of it, the Funan River, at night it would be full of prostitutes, right? And not just like regular prostitutes or just like, you know, I'll give you head for $50 or 50 RMB, right? That was regular run-of-the-mill stuff. I'm talking about like lots of ladyboys, fat women, really really tall women, really short women, crippled women, you know, crippled dudes. Like, it was where the sex workers who couldn't find a brothel went. And it's where the creepy dudes who had really specific predilections went to find what they were looking for. And that's where they met, at the riverside, at Funanhua. Me and my homie Tans and a few other homies, we used to hang out at Paul's Oasis, which was right at the river, right where a lot of these sex workers would hang out. And there was a pair. A lot of these women went in pairs. It was safer like that. And there was a pair there at the river, a pair of sex workers. One of them was a one-legged girl and the other was a dwarf. A one-legged prostitute and her dwarf companion work in the riverside in Chengdu, the capital of Sichuan province, in 2002. Think I'm playing? I'm definitely not. Okay? And I was fascinated. I did not, you know, solicit any services from them. I would admit that if I did, and I didn't. I was too fascinated. You know, I could not stop thinking about their backstories. And I wrote a story, actually, that got published somewhere. It was a long time ago, but it got published in a Chinese literary journal, or an English language Chinese journal, right? And it was called The One-Legged River Ho. It was called The One-Legged River Ho, or River Girl, River Ho. You know, I changed the title multiple times, so I'm sorry. No offense with the ho talk, my bad. But, and it was, you know, just a snippet of what their lives were like on the riverside. And I still have that story. And that story, at some point in 2018, it just took a hold of me and it became this novel that I'm working on. And it has changed so much, you know, since then. In the beginning, the one-legged girl was the main character. That's not the case anymore. Lots of things have changed. And over time, I'll tell more stories here on this channel and you know, we'll get to that. But the dwarf part of that pair became a very major character in this book, Dudran, who I mentioned before. And so yeah, her backstory, I'll repeat it here real quickly. Born in Chuxiong, some shithole in Yunnan, sold by her parents to a dwarf circus, becomes a sex worker, gets hard, you know what I'm saying, and then heads out to Chengdu, the capital, meets this one-legged girl. They become sisters. Like, their relationship is so strong. And they just rely on each other. You know, they make this money at night, giving head to all these migrant workers and random weirdos. And then they go to the clubs, you know, they party, they get a room together. And they are like Thelma and Louise, you know what I'm saying? Like, just this, they're besties. And they're just surviving out here in a period of time in China where anything can happen. And it does. Now, we find ourselves in the book, right? When the book starts, Dudran is in the city of Leshan, which is about 2 hours southeast of Chengdu. And when we find her, she's not with the one-legged girl anymore. Now she is kind of the, you know, the manager of a brothel in Leshan that is devoted to these types of girls that walk the river in the city of Chengdu, the capital. Burn victims, cripples, you know, girls with huge titties, you know, things that in China would be, you know, wild and crazy. And her, the man who actually runs the brothel is a brutal, vicious gangster who Dudran has a personal vendetta against. And that's where we start the book. So yeah, that's one of the characters. Her name's Dudran. And over the next few months, you know, I'll talk about other characters in the book. Eventually I'll talk about the main character. But for now, let's keep it right there. Dudran, dwarf princess, coming out of Chuxiong, you know, rambling through China. And now we find her in Leshan, managing a weird-ass brothel. Alright, thanks for listening. Hope you enjoyed it.
我要控制我自己，不会让谁看。 见我哭泣，装作梦。